title says, I'm just going to be exploring some sounds today. I have some stuff off to the side of here that I'm just going to use, make some sound with, just see what I like. So hopefully you enjoy that too. So without further ado,
let's get started.
So
the first item that I have today
is a aluminium foil bowl. I use this in a short YouTube short that I did. It was I used it briefly, but I realized I really enjoy the sound of it.
All of the grooves on the ball itself,
when you just rub your nails across them, sound like really pleasant. A bit more thorough and
longer lasting video with it,
because in the short that I did, it's only like 5 seconds that you hear it for.
I honestly found one of my new favorite triggers with this thing.
Just sitting here listening to myself do this is like making me just want to go fall asleep. It's really nice. Which I guess it's a weird concept to think that, you know, putting someone to sleep is the goal here. Usually you don't want to do that. But I guess it's almost funny like that. It's kind of an interesting sound. I haven't done that yet. It's just squish. squish the bowl. Interesting. Simple but effective. So the next thing that I have is quite literally just a coaster, but it's a cork coaster. It is a cork coaster, and it makes an excellent thud sound when it's tapped. Scratching the cork definitely is an interesting one as well. I was just gonna tap on it. I didn't realize that this also sounds pretty good. It does sound a little bit like sounds very similar, but you know, also the same. let's try something a little risky. I put this on the microphone itself. No, okay, we're not gonna do that. We're not gonna do that. I'll just do it above it. Stuff that I do, I might try and implement some of these sounds that I'm exploring today whilst I do some visual stuff. But that'll be for a different video. Let's move on to the next item. Here we have something that can be pretty risky. Any sudden movement with this? This is always like fantastic opening up lids and things. That sound. Sound never fails to sound good to me. Right, let's see if I can do this without making a lot of noise. Most popular die, most recognized die would be the 20. Come on, camera. It's the 20-sided die. It doesn't want to show you. But the 20-sided die. Then we have a 4-sided die. We have an 8-sided die. We have a, what is this, a 9, I'm pretty sure. No, 10. It's a 10-sided die. So we have a 10-sided die. And what's this? 12. We have a 12-sided die. And then 2. And then another 10-sided die. But in integers of 10. So you use that in combination with the 10-sided die to do a D100. So you get a number from 1 to 100, or 0 to 99. It sounds like chewing. Like someone biting on something. It cut between my hands. I'm just like grabbing at them. Do like a mouth sounds video, but with not actual mouth sounds. Interesting concept to try out. See if I can replicate mouth sounds without actually doing the mouth sounds. Let's just take two of these. Those two. And we're just gonna, like as if I'm about to roll them. Do it a bit further away, so it's not too harsh. There's two of them. There's not one. That'd be it probably for these. There's only so much I can do with them. Tapping it is a bit. It sounds like every other tapping. Not really anything new with that, but the clacking of the die. Alright, let's see if I can. You guys, for anyone who stuck around, I give you guys a bit of some visually stuff while I talk it in this outro. I know people really like visual stuff. Hell, I'm a fan of it too, but this is the end. Goodbye. I know I only did three different sounds in this one, but honestly, so 40 minutes of filming just went down the tube. But I guess it's all a learning experience, isn't it? But thank you for watching this video. If there was anything you heard that was, you know, that did it for you, gave you ASMR, let me know, and I'll try and include it in another video. No, also do like a sound exploration with the visual stuff. Maybe do layered sounds in future.